Guys, Nick Jennison for GI. On the test bench today, we are taking a look at the new revised Archon 50 from our friends at Paul Reed Smith. Now, you're likely familiar with the Archon line of amplifiers as PRS's high gain, screaming, soaring, searing, all of those adjectives, metal amps with tons and tons of gain, but also with a really sweet, sparkly, clean channel. This is absolutely still the case in this amplifier. However, there are some crucial updates, not least of which is the new lower price point, which puts this amp within grasp for a lot more players. However, there are a few other tweaks that I want to talk about, and I'm going to show you a whole variety of tones that are available within this amp. Before we do that, however, you've heard me playing with a ton of gain. We're playing through my PRS CE24 with a pair of Fishman Fluence Devin Townsend humbuckers. We're in the active sounding voice one for the first little demo that you heard. Let's take a listen to the clean channel on this amp, and for this, we're going to go into the split coil voice 2, which is a single coil type voice. Let's take a listen to that now. So while that's fresh in your mind, before we get too deep into the specifications, let's take a listen to this amp with an entirely different guitar, a completely different setup entirely. We're going to go to standard tuning with a Paul Reed Smith Silver Sky, which has low output, vintage inspired 60s-ish single coils. Let's try the exact same settings on the dirt channel and on the clean channel, and let's take a listen to how that sounds.
Thank you.
So now we've heard this amp played with two very different guitars, both clean and dirty, let's talk a little more about the specifications. Now, what we're looking at here is the 50 watt combo version, which comes equipped with a Celestion V-type speaker, which is a little closer to the Greenback sound than it is the Vintage 30, even though it has that V kind of classification. It's not really very Vintage 30 sounding, which is an interesting choice, but it is quite a big and bold speaker, which sounds pretty good in the combo, as I'm sure you'll agree. We will explore it through some Vintage 30s in a moment. It also uses an interesting power tube. There are two 6CA7s, which according to Paul Reed Smith, sits somewhere between an EL34 and a 6L6 in terms of tone. Certainly an interesting choice, and this amp does kind of have a little bit of that kind of big, bold 6L6 character, but there's still some of that growl that you'd expect from more of a British tube type. Now, in terms of the front panel, what we're dealing with is a two-channel design. We have a lead channel, which is where all of that filthy gain comes from, and we have a clean channel. Each has a volume, which is probably better thought of as a gain channel, or rather a gain knob, a three-band EQ, which is insanely powerful. I'll show you that in a moment. A bright switch, which is gonna add some extra sizzle before the distortion, which is gonna kind of open the sound up or focus it more in the mids, depending upon where you set it. And likewise, it's gonna add some extra chime on the bright channel, and on the clean channel. And lastly, we have a master control for each channel, which is probably best thought of as a volume control. So you have gain, EQ, volume. There's also a master presence and a master depth. We've got the depth turned up pretty high because this is a 112 combo. It's not the biggest cabinet in the world, so turning the depth up is gonna add a little bit of that kind of 4x12-ish rumble. However, if you're running through a larger speaker cabinet, you might think about maybe turning the depth down and the presence up to match. It's really just a question of tailoring these to the cab you're playing through and the room you're playing in. Now, one other very cool update that is just gold for someone like me is Paul Reed Smith have done away with the proprietary foot switch jack that was on the older Archon 50s and given us a standard quarter inch foot switch to change the channels with. Now, not only does this mean that if you lose your foot switch, you aren't stuck, it also means if, like me, you use a switching system and switch your amp's channels remotely, you can do that without having to use a custom made cable, which is big because lots of people control their amps this way. So that is a really nice update. In addition to that, we have the usual quota of speaker jacks on the rear panel, which gives you the capacity to run into a variety of external cabinets. We have an effects loop, which is a serial design, send and return, really the best kind of effects loop for heavy amplifiers, in my opinion. And the aforementioned foot switch jack. We also have external bias points too, so you can adjust your amp's bias without having to take it to bits, which is nice. Again, another fine addition, although I think that was on the previous Archon, but you know, either way, a nice thing to see. Also, the front panel has been changed from the brushed aluminium design to this kind of like black, it's almost like a wood effect kind of design. It looks very, very classy, certainly not as brash as the previous Archon, and it doesn't add quite as much weight. So it's a little bit lighter if you're a traveling musician, which is especially important in a combo format like this. So that's the specifications. Let's take a listen to some more sounds. So the first example I want to show you is we're going to have a little bit of a play with the gain range on the dirty channel. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the gain at 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock, and then 3 o'clock. And I'm also going to engage and disengage the bright switch to show you what effect that has on the gain channel sound at various gain ranges. Let's take a listen to that now.
Thank you.
what's interesting here is even winding the gain down to its lower reaches and engaging the bright switch to open the sound up a little bit, we still have this very tight, focused American style distortion, but perhaps not as grainy or kind of brash as some other amps that maybe kind of fit that same description. It's not really a classic rock kind of sound, and if you're kind of looking for those sounds in the distortion channel, you may be disappointed, but for all kinds of modern hard rock and metal, there's just a whole rainbow of tones available, and we haven't even touched the EQ yet. And of course, there is absolutely humongous amounts of gain. Now, you may be thinking, that's far too much gain for me. I'm never going to need that much. Why have they put that much gain in? Well, if you have a guitar with single coil pickups, maybe you're doing the Malmsteen thing or the Blackmore thing and you're playing, you know, metal on a Strat, it's very popular in power metal, for example, you're going to need that extra gain range to get you into that same level of saturation that a guitar like this with hot pickups would achieve in the lower gain ranges. So it is there for a reason and it's there to be used. Now, let's do the same test on the clean channel. We're not going to go right down to 9 o'clock because this channel stays pretty clean and chimey and very, very high headroomy sounding all the way up to at least 12. So we're going to start there and then we'll max out the gain and we'll explore the effect of the bright switch on both of these gain settings. So the gain control on the clean channel is actually very, very usable, and it's probably better thought of as like a maybe like a saturation control or almost like a compression control, because as you start to turn things up, you just get a little bit more of that touch sensitive compression, especially with the bright switch engaged. However, if you want the highest of high headroom cleans, you can actually still do that at about 12 o'clock and get a really bright, chiming, super clear clean sound, which again is really appropriate for more aggressive styles of music when you want to contrast that heavy distortion with a really sparkling clean sound. So next up, let's take a listen to the EQ. And for this, we're going to focus solely on the distortion channel because the EQs are voiced very similarly and you can really hear the effect most prominently on the gain channel. So let's take a listen to that now. We'll be right back. until this point, we've been listening to the Archon 50 combo through the built-in Celestion V-type speaker, which we've mic'd up with our SM57. Let's do the same configuration, but this time we're going to contrast it against our V30 4x12, which is mic'd up in our ISO booth. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the same example, or near enough the same example. I'll try my best. I'm going to play it twice. First of all, through the onboard speaker, and then we'll take a listen to how it sounds through vintage 30s. This will give you an impression of how the Archon 50 head might sound through a typical industry standard V30 412. So now we've heard most of the tones that this amp is able to produce on its own, let's see how well it handles some pedals. We're going to do a few examples here. First of all, we're going to explore the clean channel with a pretty thick and spitty sounding fuzz, specifically a Red Witch Fuzz God 2. We're going to throw this into the clean channel with the bright switch disengaged, and then we'll flip the bright switch on and we'll hear what effect that has on our tone. So what's interesting here is the bright switch has a really profound effect on the sound of our pedals. I mean, you would expect that from a super high headroom clean amp with a bright switch. If you've ever used a Deluxe, for example, with the bright switch on and off, you'll know what I'm talking about. It is a little bit more measured on the Archon 50, though. It's not quite as drastic as flipping the bright switch on an old Fender, in that both sounds are actually pretty usable and they're fairly close to each other. But it's a really good way to tailor the sound of your drive pedals if you get the majority of your tone from drive sounds, or maybe you want like a lower gain sound to complement the super high headroom clean and crazy focused gain that are on board on this app. So the next example we're going to try is the classic TS-808 boost. We're going to do this first of all into the distortion channel, and we'll use that time-tested volume up, gain down configuration. So the volume is going to be set pretty high, very close to maximum. We'll set the tone about 2 o'clock and we'll turn the gain off. First of all, we'll hear the distortion sound without the pedal, then I'll kick it on and we'll hear what difference that makes. So while this amp's distortion sound is certainly tight enough that it doesn't really need a boost to work in pretty much any metal setting, it does add a little bit of something, just a certain kind of extra push. So if you're really, really into that TS-808 boosted kind of sound, this amp is going to take that very well. Now, speaking of tube screamers, let's try the same pedal, but this time with the gain turned up and the volume set to unity, into the clean channel, and we'll see if we can get kind of a purring modern blues kind of sound. So it's reassuring that if this amp has some of the sounds you're after, but maybe not all of them, because it does kind of exist on the extreme, so to speak. We've got this very vicious distortion channel and this super sparkly high headroom clean. The clean channel is pedal friendly enough that you can get any of those kind of in-between tones with your favorite stomp boxes. So that is pretty reassuring. Now, the last pedal we're gonna try is I'm gonna throw on a different kind of boost. This time we're gonna use a Sur Coco boost, which is just a straight mid boost. We'll throw on some reverb and delay, and we'll see if we can get a really great singing, searing lead sound. So there you go, guys. This is the updated PRS Archon 50. This is the combo version, but a head version is also available if you prefer to run it through your cab of choice. But the combo also sounds pretty fantastic. Now, it does live, like I say, very much on the tonal extremes of the spectrum. We have a beautiful, sparkling, clean channel and a really focused, thick, fat, vicious distortion channel. But of course, the clean channel is friendly enough to take pedals if you want to get some of those in-between tones. It's a really great sounding amplifier. It's going to suit a particular kind of player, I think, very, very well indeed. And I'm a huge fan of that lead channel in particular. I think it sounds absolutely phenomenal. So one more time, this is the Archon 50 from Paul Reed Smith. My name is Nick Jennison for GI. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked what you saw, be sure to check out the links that you can see right here for more videos on more of the same. I'm sure you're gonna like them just as much. Also, don't forget to click the like and subscribe buttons, which are somewhere down here, and this little bell icon, which is gonna let us notify you when we drop new videos. And you can check out the exclusive lesson platform, GI Plus, which is available at the link in the description. I think you're gonna love it.